Okay, this is part two of the antibiotic review, and we will be going into, first we're going over the specific indications that you can use vancomycin for, and I like to think of the HOMES acronym. So it starts out with H is for healthcare acquired pneumonia, O is going to be for osteomyelitis, M is going to be meningitis, E is endocarditis, and S is for sepsis. So that's going to be the indications for first line for vanco. And then we're moving into our altered cell membrane. So this is going to be our cyclic lipopeptide. Specifically, it's going to be daptomycin. And this can be used also for in replace of vancomycin too. The main difference is that daptomycin, it does not concentrate in the lung, because our lung actually has a specific surfactant in it that kind of deactivates the daptomycin. So can't use this for the healthcare acquired pneumonia. But the way that this works is it causes a depolarization in the cell to kind of, and it loses its structures and falls apart that way. Then we move into our nucleic acid synthesis, specifically our fluoroquinolones. And these are going to work on something called topoisomerase, which is going to, that's an enzyme that works to kind of break down the DNA when it's unwinding. So we're inhibiting the topoisomerase, which acts like scissors to help the unwinding process. So it kind of causes a lot of DNA breaks. So the three different ones that we have are going to be our ciprofloxacin, our levofloxacin, and our moxifloxacin. And the main difference between these two, I put them in order of alphabetical order, but it also happens to work out based on side effect profile too. So moxifloxacin is going to be the have the most severe side effects, where cipro is going to have the least severe side effects. And those side effects are going to be the neuropathy and then the tendon rupture and QTC prolongation. Also with tendon rupture, it's very likely to be increased with steroid use as well. So that's why I put that here too. And then two other things that I wanted to point out. So for ciprofloxacin, it is not considered a respiratory fluoroquinolone. So we can only use our levoquin and our moxifloxacin for respiratory infections. And that's mainly because it doesn't have very good strep pneumo coverage. And then we can't use moxifloxacin for UTI infections because it doesn't concentrate in the urine. So that's going to be the main difference between those. Then we move into our protein synthesis inhibitors. And so I broke these down based upon their ribosomal subunit. Their ribosomal subunits. So we have our 30S and our 50S ribosomal subunits. And ribosomes are used to help produce proteins. So these are going to inhibit the specific subunits to produce those proteins. So our aminoglycosides are going to work at our 30S subunits. And these are going to be, I made the acronym TAGs to help remember. So we have tobramycin, amikacin, gentamicin, and streptomycin. And these really, I like to focus on toxicity. So nephrotoxic and ootoxic. So these are primarily used not as first line medications. They're used kind of more last line for more severe infections when a lot of our other indications haven't worked. Then we have our tetracyclines, and the two that I picked out here are going to be the minocycline and the doxycycline. And main side effect to focus on this one is going to be teeth discoloration. So we don't use it in younger children, because when they're developing, it can cause a gray tooth syndrome, and this can affect them for the rest of their lives. So avoid it in young children. Then we have our 50S ribosomal subunits, and we have three different medication classes that fall in here. So first we have our macrolides, and these are going to be our thromycin. So macrolide and thro is how I remember. So azithromycin, clarithromycin, and erythromycin. And main side effect with these are going to be our QTC prolongation. So I like to think cardiac side effects with these ones. Then we have our lincosamide. And this is just going to be clindamycin or cleacin, and C. difficile is going to be something that we want to watch out for. There's a black box warning for clindamycin for C. difficile. And then last but not least, we have our linezolid and tadalafil. Linezolid is going to be Zyvox. And main side effect profiles that we're going to have here are going to be the neuropathy and serotonin syndrome, because these also act as monoamine oxidase inhibitors as well.